Thrombolysis in myocardial infarction. Chronology of development of thrombolytic agents. First generation, streptokinase, APSAC. Second generation, Alteplase, recombinant tissue plasminogen activator. Third generation, Reteplase, Lanoteplase, Tenecteplase or TNK-TPA. Characteristics of an ideal thrombolytic agent. Long half-life, single-bolus administration, high fibrin specificity, decreased bleeding and intracranial hemorrhage, resistant to PAI-1, rapid action, reduction in 30-day mortality, no effect on blood pressure, no antigenicity, no re-occlusion, compatible with other intravenous agents. An ideal thrombolytic agent is yet to be developed. Streptokinase was the first fibrinolytic to be extensively used in acute myocardial infarction. It is a bacterial protein from group C beta streptococcus. Streptokinase complexes with plasminogen and converts plasminogen to plasmin. Two placebo-controlled trials, GC and ISIS-2, demonstrated the effectiveness of thrombolysis in acute myocardial infarction with streptokinase and documented the benefit in terms of mortality reduction. Disadvantages or limitations of streptokinase. Streptokinase requires 1 hour for administration and it is not a direct activator of plasmin. Neither is it fibrin specific. Hence, there is a chance for increased systemic bleeding. Streptokinase is immunogenic and allergic reactions can occur rarely. Its effectiveness is decreased if given between 5 days to 12 months of prior use. Alteplase, recombinant tissue plasminogen activator, is cloned from human TPA. Unlike streptokinase, it is non-immunogenic. It has a short half-life of 4 to 8 minutes. Hence, it has to be administered over a period of 90 minutes. The 90-minute schedule is an accelerated infusion compared to the longer period of infusion which was used earlier. Alteplase has been shown to reduce mortality in GASTO1 trial. Disadvantages or limitations of Alteplase. Since it has to be given as an intravenous infusion, pre-hospital use is impractical or difficult. Even the accelerated schedule takes 90 minutes to administer. Alteplase is inhibited by plasminogen activator inhibitor PAI-1. Reteplase is the first genetically modified TPA. It is non-immunogenic like TPA. Reteplase has a longer half-life permitting usage as double bolus 30 minutes apart. Its efficacy is comparable to TPA and has been documented by GASTO3 trial. Disadvantages or limitations of Reteplase. 30 minutes are required for administration. It is less fibrin specific than Alteplase. Reteplase is not resistant to PAI-1. Lanoteplase. Lanoteplase is a mutant of wild-type TPA. It is fibrin selective and has a half-life of 37 minutes, permitting usage as a single bolus. But Lanoteplase causes an increased incidence of intracranial hemorrhage and hence its usage has been discontinued. Tenecteplase is genetically engineered variant of Alteplase. It can be administered as single bolus and it is resistant to inactivation by PAI-1. Tenecteplase is fibrin specific. It is useful for pre-hospital thrombolysis. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.